very close to starting this game. And here we go. It's going to be delivery again. We have seen delivery quite a lot. This is the upper bracket final. And it's between Visual 2, who kind of shocked the odds in their semi-final, beating Visual 1 against Dux. As you can see, it's going to be Hybratech, Gizmo, and Blade with some random name Dynamite against Stray, Fireball, and Cresty. We're going to see that Dynamite go down very quickly. Sniper Rifle is in the hands of Gizmo. He's going to get in quite a few hits. Cresty not really aware of the angle there. He's very fortunate to still be alive. Hybratech gets that frag onto Stray, and Stray is sort of a meat bag. You see Blade pushing into this lower area. He is going to make his way towards... He's going to just be really, really lame here. It's a good play. They don't know where he's going exactly. Stray has sort of fallen back. Cresty gets taken down. Hybratech's going to move in for the flag. He is going to get taken down by Stray. And one more player alive. It is going to be Gizmo. Gets taken down himself. And they know Blade is hiding. They don't know where. And they all spawn back because of it. They're not 100% certain. He tried to get the pre-shot off. It's not going to happen for him. He's going to get a lot of damage onto Fireball, but he receives a lot in return. And he's going to get shut down. But that play basically forced the entire kill out of the German team. All of the Dux players killed out because Blade just lingered. He just lingered there. They weren't sure if he was an engineer. They didn't know the full situation. Really nice play from Blade. We're not going to now see what they can do on their attack. Hybratech's going to lead the charge, as the engineers normally do. Going to need a medic hot on his tail. It's always going to be Gizmo. Gizmo's really going to be smart with that. Nice shooting. Oh, the Gib was close. Brilliant revive comes in. Stray's going to run away. He has his tail between his legs. He's not happy with that one. Reply frag does come in, but it's going to be the normal nice revive so far. And they're going to see exactly what we see every time. It's going to be that revive in the doorway. Gizmo's going to be able to get that frag. Hybratech picks up another. And it's going to be Stray. Double frag comes in, and Stray continues his dominance. He has been playing very well today. He's going to push forward. They are risking full spawn here, but they're going to go straight for that flag. Is one player alive. It is going to be Blade again, just to annoy them. Just to annoy them in the back. He's going to do exactly the same thing. And it's going to force the Dux team to give up this flag. They're going to give up this flag. After 5 seconds, they're going to kill out here. I can't see them trying to hold on. So you do see them kill out. They're just trying to slow them down a little bit. Now, where's Blade? Where's he hiding? He could be anywhere. He's in the bottom room. Makes sense. Blade goes out. Ooh. Force tap out for the win. Saves the day. We're going to pick up Hybratech once more. He's going to be leading. He's got Gizmo right behind him, playing that medic role. Yeah, very supportive medic, but he's going to get dropped. And revived almost instantaneously. Language, please. As we're going to see the push into the office. It's the size to kill out. Both teams respawning back in at the same time here. So push coming towards this upper area. It's going to need a grenade in. You're going to see again the normal stuff. Doorway. Revive. Push through. Fireball takes down Gizmo. And the push through the spawn area was too slow and not very good either. Cresty just destroyed Blade there. The 6-on-6 teammates coming face to face. Blade gets taken down. And another push on towards the office. Gonna stick with Blade. He's gonna lead the charge this time. He's gonna go first. He's not gonna do the revive in the doorway. It's gonna be head first into that button room just before the spawn time. He has sort of eliminated grenades and stuff from the axis. Cresty gets one out. It's a bit of damage in. Fireball pushes forwards, gets another kill. He's going to push through, trying to take down the medics, but he's going to over pushed himself. Nice grenade comes out from Stray. Hybratech pushes in. It's going to have to be Cresty to pick up the big frags. He does get in a revive as well, but I think the build is going to come in on the controls, and they are indeed. Lots of frags coming in, though. Stray gets another two or three there, but it's not going to be enough. They have done the build, and that's pretty decent timing. They're going to probably aim for... You want to aim for around about a 7 or 8 minute time on deliveries. Like that mid-standard. Anything better than that is awesome. As an access team, you want as much as possible. You'll take it all. Every second counts. Nice push. Grenade comes out. Blade's not going to be able to put that frag. Hybratech pushing in once more. And they actually decide to kill out. Hybratech taps out, so Blade's left with his needle out. And quick fancy... Push now across the top. Questy's going to take out Blade. He actually took out Blade before his feet hit the ground. He jumped and was dead in midair. I think Questy was actually almost holding him up, lightning gun style in Quake. It's really nice to see. His defense at the button is doing a good job. Now seeing him getting plenty of frags. There was one small mistake, I feel, from Fireball, where he pushed on through and got eliminated and put a lot of pressure on the remaining medics. It's going to be a lot of pressure on Fireball now. 15 seconds. He's going to get overwhelmed. Gizmo's going to just completely push through. Double frag for him. And now they've got the button. Have they got the objective? They have. Gizmo's going to push. He's going to be able to get there in time. Button pressure will come in, but he just secures it in time. And that's the better, should I say, the better truck to put the gold in. It's the furthest one away. It can be hardest to get to. We are going to see the second gold crate get picked up and the push towards the office now. Hypertech going to try and put on a bit of pressure. He's all by himself. He hasn't got a teammate behind him. I do hear some footsteps. Maybe he's getting some support. Cresti gets in that frag. Very weak. Team Kill comes in. Revive, though. And we'll probably hear a revive from Hypertech very soon. Actually, Hypertech decides to tap out. Push on this next push. And he's got LAN in his name, just to make sure we all know he's definitely playing at LAN right now. He's done his job. He did his job. Die in the doorway. But we do see Blade actually push through the side. And where's the button push? Where's the button push? Come on, Blade. I think Blade must have got that spawn kill. And Gizmo with the double frag through window. And that is just so surprising. How did they get double frag through window? 6 minutes 22. 13 frags for Stray. 2k damage. Like I said, today he's been really on fire, and in 3-on-3 you need to be on fire. 6-on-6, no, it's not so much. I don't think that he needs to play massive in 6-on-6, but in 3-on-3. Cresty getting 12 frags as well. But across the other team, Gizmo did really well. He was the objective carrier, and he's getting the most frags. Hypertech was just like, he had lots of deaths. He's just doing those doorway deaths. We've seen it a lot. 2k damage. He did his job. He got the build in. Everything was good, and now it's going to be down to the attack of the Ducks team. Capture the forward bunker. They have 6 minutes 20 seconds. 6 minutes 20 seconds. It's going to decide the first map winner. Not 100% sure who the map was picked by, but I'm assuming it was picked by a visual, because Ducks have already picked it. Nice boost, and they're going to be able to pick up the flag on the respawn. Brilliant push for the ally team. They are going to be able to take down one. Oh, nearly a full to the death. He did manage to heal midair. I think he would have had a little bit of health left, but the engineer's pushed all the way through, and it's going to be straight to get the build. No defense in position, and they've managed to do like what, 2-3 stages in less than a minute's time. What is going on with this visual defense? Come on, boys, come on, give us a game. They're getting set up now in the button room. And this is actually pretty formidable defense. Hypertech, Gizmo, and Blade, all big aimers. All big potential. Here comes the push from the allies. Objective secure. Nades come out. And that's just going to slow them down. And respawn will come back in, but this is what Visual need to do. They need to make every little thing count. One kill here, one kill there. Just stop them getting towards that button area. They haven't. Oh, they have pressed the button. What was going on there? What just happened? I'm completely baffled. I thought they had control. The Axis were just sitting in the office doing nothing. I'm not sure what's going on. What the hell? What the hell just happened there? I'm lost, guys. I'm completely lost. The Axis had, I thought, full control of this button room. It didn't press the button. Oh my god. Isn't the door still open? Yeah, that's what I thought. I thought, what is going on? They had control. They messed up. That was a big mistake. So that's one crate gone. 4 minutes for the second crate. And they're going to be tilted right now. They're going to be really pissed off with each other and themselves. They know they messed up. Gizmo in the last room is going to get that double frag, though. Stray and Cresty both shut down. And that is really nice from Gizmo. And they're going aggressive again. Have they pressed the button this time? Hopefully they have. Gizmo's going to continue it. He's going to get another... He's going to loop all the way around. Going to get into that button room. I've got Blade going aggressive. He's going to get a kill out before he kills out. Kill out before he kills out. And he's going to go down to the lower area. Push on towards the button. He's going to come in. Stray and Fireball. They have the time where they can actually push in as a three-man team and sort of risk the objective. It's kind of risky. But you don't want to be in that last push situation where you actually have to give it up. And they are going to press the button. Now it's Operation Transmit. It's all on Blade. It's all on Blade. He's going to catch Stray out. Stray with his packs out. Stray can't count to three. He counted one, two. I'm sure they're all dead. And you're going to see Blade just hold on to the objective in this low area and get as much time as possible off the clock. It's going to distract him a bit. He heard the legs break of Stray. Brilliant shot by Blade. Kind of standard what we can't come to expect from the German. Push across the upper area from Hypertech, just trying to gather some information. But Cresty's going to be able to make it into the bottom room against Gizmo. And that was risky. Both players were on full spawn. And it was probably more important that Gizmo came out on top, because a full spawn for a defender is actually really, really a problem. A full spawns for an attacker, it was closer to half the time, 15 seconds, so it's not too bad. They are running out of time though. 2 minutes, 2 minutes, 5 seconds. 2 minute one is going to be very close.
2 minutes to get out of here, soldier.
And Blade and Visual, Blade and Gizmo, been just utilizing these train areas and these box areas a lot, just distracting the... The ducks pushes, trying to push into this upper area now, and I think that's going to be Blade again. They love it. It's going to be Blade. He's in position to stop an objective holder come forward. He has been spotted by Fireball. Brilliant shot by Fireball. Shut down. They have pushed the button as well, and they are going to be able to get the objective in the back of the truck. That is going to be the first map for the ducks team. And Visual, I think those early stages and the mistake, the big mistake. I mean, you could look at the time, a minute and a half, and they made the mistake. The button, they didn't press the button. They lost the flag and they went straight through and got the builds. I mean, that is a minute and a half, guys. That is an easy defense to add that sort of time on. Their attack was really nice. In my mind, they kind of threw that away. Germans, the Ducks team took full advantage, no doubt. I mean, you can't take anything away from them, but... I mean, look at Gizmo, 4k damage, 23 frags, he was beasting. And they lose the map. He got more than 1k damage more than everyone else. He got only a little bit more kills than Cresty. But that is... I think they're going to be really disappointed with that. They've got to just, like, get that out of their minds now. They've got to be just like, okay, we messed up. This happens. We've got top three, boys. Let's just try and get our heads in the game. We can come back. You saw Ducks come back last game. Can Visual do that as well? It's going to be difficult. They could have won. But this is what it's like at this level. Mistakes that cost you objectives are big. Like missing a spawn. We saw people miss spawns. That happens. Those do add up. However, not closing the gate, not closing the barrier, and losing an entire crate objective. I mean, say they didn't do that, and this was when the first crate got in. So they would have a minute and a half for the last crate. Now, that would be really hard for the Germans. Advantage Visual. Because of that mess up, and I saw in chat, I think it was Raz saying, that's happened twice today. I remember it was sometimes like, the button wouldn't press if it was halfway open and halfway closed. That's just one of them things. Okay, I'm back. Map 2, Ice. What? This is a map I know, boys. This is a map I know. But right now they're going into the UFO room. I'm joking. As they're going to push down north. The Hypertech guys going to go towards that plant objective. Hypertech's going to be able to get that down on the old door. Yeah, I have got an ally to deal with. It's going to be Stray and Cresty. And Hypertech gets in that frag. Brilliant stuff from Hypertech. Nearly worked. And Stray tapped out, I think. He would have been able to get that defuse in. Not sure why he tapped out. Maybe it was very close to the spawn time. But the Axis had picked up the flag. Two players in that flag room, both getting taken down. The Cresty Fireball pincer maneuver just really working to perfection there. We do see Cresty pushing up on North. He has got that lean on. He's got his lean on. Nate comes out. Hyper Tech taken down. Revive will come in. Doesn't get gibbed. Oh. That bullet actually could have gibbed. That could have gibbed because he would have taken some damage on the fall. But it's all good. Fireball just on fire. Fireball's going to be so confident, guys. I'm going to give you the heads up. You look at these teams. Hyper Tech, Gizmo, Blade, Fireball, Cresty, Stray. Fireball has played this map 100 times more than everyone else here. He played it all the time in RCW. This is an RCW map. This was one of the like top three played maps in RCW for a long period. And it's going to be mad confidence for Fireball. Look at this. Hyper Tech doesn't even know what's going on. He just got destroyed. Cresty gets that double frag though on North as well. And they're going to push out. Respawn comes in for the Axis. They decide to back off. Cresty is in position. He's going to sit at the back of these halls. You can jump up on the top of these boxes. And Fireball just installed a new mouse. And again, more confidence. It's going to be very confident in a moment. So you see three-man push down North. Yeah, I'm going to get a couple of frags in. Oh, that's actually team kills. Is that more team kills? Is that three times Hyper Tech's... No, two times Hyper Tech's been killed, team killed by Blade there. Still watching Cresty. Push from the Axis come in. No grenades on in the allied hand, so no easy gibs. Nice push over the top, but he's not going to be able to get that frag. And so many frags coming in for the Ducks. Any reply would be good, and it's going to be one frag for Gizmo, but I think he actually got a gib in. As maybe going to be able to take over that flag area. Only two players alive for the allies. We did see Fireball pick up a couple more frags as well, and like I said, playing on ice with a new mouse. He's had mice? He's had issues with his mouse all day, where it's been like locking up or changing some profiles on his drivers. So without that, he's going to be very confident. Cresty's going to get a brilliant shot off on Gizmo. Gizmo's just going to be like, what the hell happened? I had him dead to rights, but it's not going to be the case. Respawn comes in. Fireball's going to take a bit of damage from Hyper Tech. He is going to be able to make it through that main gate in the near the ally complex. The hill respawn for Cresty is going to take Hyper Tech a little bit by surprise, but Blade and Gizmo have a bit of control in these north halls. I think you've got Gizmo pushing up that long area. The flag has actually been reclaimed by Cresty. Gizmo trying to getting a bit of harassment now. He knows he's all by himself. He knows it's going to be a while before he gets any sort of backup. And he's just trying to distract a couple of players. He should be able to hear a lot of footsteps here. Gizmo's actually going to move in on the objective. He is going to get taken down. But Stray and Fireball both are sort of taken out of the game for 10-15 seconds. And that has allowed the Axis to push forward and reclaim that forward bunker, as it's called in this game, as the flag is reclaimed. Yeah, forward spawn is always available to reclaim, which is a real problem. Like, something that some ET players will not be used to. In RCW, this is a norm. The flags, respawn areas, always reclaimable. Whereas in ET, a lot of the time when you destroy an objective, it actually makes it so the flag's always yours. So it can be quite hard to deal with as an attacking team. It's slightly different to what you're used to. But they are going for that up top defense. I am not a fan of the up top defense at all. In 3-on-3, you can get rolled over anyway. Doesn't matter where you defend, but up top, well, you leave yourself up open to so many angles. You have to spread out quite a lot to be able to defend it all. And right now, taking their time. Cresty's just right here. What is going on? Gizmo's just like, how has he been alive for that long? Cresty was just, I think he was leaning the ladder still. They're going to have a couple of players to deal with. Hyper Tech is in the lower position. Cresty manages to get one frag in. He is going to get a bit of damage onto Hyper Tech. Hyper Tech manages to finish that off. Fireball pushes down. He knows the business. He's going to be able to force the kill out from Hyper Tech. So half the time nearly off the clock. Nearly 5 minutes remaining. Here comes the push in North. Look, that's Fireball. That's a pitch perfect RCW nade, but he just mistimed it. Whereas in ET, you might not know that stuff. It sounds stupid. That's experience for you. Like, map experience on this map. Fireball has got like 700 times Blade sort of thing, and everyone else is like, I don't know, 50, you know? In terms of pracs and officials, you know? We have captured the And that is a big difference. Forward bunker has been reclaimed by the Axis. Sneaky push again by Cresty, trying to take that flag, just trying to push them back. Make them spawn back, adds about another 30 seconds to the clock regardless. They will pick up that flag again, most likely, but more time on the clock. Big push from Blade, he's going well aggressive. No one in position on this long ladder. He's going to have to lean, he's going to have Stray to deal with the objective. Stray's been playing this objective the entire time. Fireball does get one frag. It's the lean off. Leaning against each other. Self kills do come in. And he's going to get the call. Blade's going to be coming. Oh, bit bad lean there. That was bad. He is going to be able to get that. Oh, it's actually a team kill. Gizmo takes down his teammate. And Gizmo! Gizmo. No. Oh, Gizmo falls to his death. He was shot mid-air, but... Well, it still counts as falling to your death, unfortunately. So here comes the push from Fireball. He's going to go very aggressive in these north halls. He's going to have a couple of guys to deal with. And it's a bit slow. A bit slow from the Axis. Again, it's a bit too non-urgent. There's not enough urgency here. I think this is map confidence. I think this is a mix. And he goes up top. That can actually do some damage. It didn't manage to get over the top of the ladder. And they've got that three-man up top defense still. Cresty manages to get in one frag. He's going to push across to his teammate. They have still got players to deal with. Nade towards the long ladder. Doesn't manage to take anyone down. He's on the pistol for 20 seconds. This could be problematic. Gizmo manages to get that airstrike off. Might take down Stray. It isn't. Cresty's just happy to be on that. Happy to be on that pistol. That's why. He manages to get that frag in. A little bit of help from Fireball there. And if they get full held here, I think it's GG. I think it's 100% GG if they get full held. I'm not sure if they'll play it out, but that'll be pretty disappointing, I think. They would probably expect to have done better. I think most people would probably look at this game and say they lost it on delivery, where they had the perfect opportunity. Nice long range shooting from Fireball. Double ACP frag comes out from Cresty as well. And Fireball's going to just ski along the snow and decides to kill out. Big respawn actually comes in from the allies, and maybe a bit of freedom for Axis to move up, but they're nowhere in position. And it just allows the allies to get back on top. No airstrike's going to come out. And it's really hard to penetrate this up top defense in ET, it seems. Not as much, nowhere near as much airstrike availability for the Axis, unfortunately, because of the recharge times. And how much charge you actually need to do airstrikes. So clearing up these like really dug in defenses is actually really difficult to do. You're gonna see Gizmo actually push up into this upper area. It's gonna have all three players to deal with. Hybrid Tech's gonna be able to get the objective, and they've got Fireball to deal with as well. Hybrid Tech's gonna be able to pick him up. He is gonna go across the top. Cresty is somewhere, unless they've already killed him and I didn't notice. The ski down from the upper area is gonna come out. No slowdown is gonna come in. Hybrid Tech's going to be able to make it into the south halls. He is going to strafe along. No one in position that I can see. Cresty, nowhere to be seen. Cresty somewhere, but I don't think he's going to make it. Hybrid Tech and Gizmo are going to be able to run this home, no problem at all. They're going to be able to set a time, and that was it. They needed a time here to have any chance in this tournament, or any chance in this upper bracket final, should I say. But 9 minutes, 12 seconds is not great. 9 minutes, 12 seconds is not great. When you see it, you're only getting 14 frags in 10 minutes. It's just over one frag a minute, nearly. It means you're not attacking enough. And even your deaths, they're only getting 4 deaths a minute. And considering I think they spawn 2 or 3 times in a minute. So yeah. Yoko playing Osu whenever he dies to keep his aim warm. Okay. Okay then. In between games, I can understand. But in between deaths is kind of like extreme. Hey. So they've got 9 minutes to get this done. 9 minutes, 12 seconds, the Ducks team. They have got that 2-0 lead. If they win this game, it is GG. Need a medic. And we will see the Ducks go on to the grand final. With the Visual 2 guys dropping down to the lower bracket final. Where they would face potentially Visual again. Visual number one. Trick Jump. Brainstorm or Cat in the Hat. I'm not 100% sure of the results there. People will probably fill me in chat in a second. Here comes the Strafes down the snow. They're going to reach the flag. Hybrid Tech's going to have that nade out. And he's going to be able to get it through the vents. Snowfrag comes in. He's going to keep the spam going. This nade is actually pretty nice. No matter what iteration of the game you're going to be using. Plant goes down straight. Gets that plant down on the service door. And at the moment, the ally team are being very defensive. You need to be quite aggressive on this flag defense. One Gib comes in. Nice play from Cresty. Brilliant pistol shots from Cresty. Gets that second frag in. The revives are going to come in for the ally team. They are going to push towards that plant. They've got Fireball and Stray to deal with. They're actually going to wait for that plant to blow, I think. Where did Stray go? Stray must have killed out. Here comes the push. Stray's going to go towards south. Fireball has already made it all the way through. He heard footsteps. He got kind of surprised there. Double man push on south. They're going to go towards that flag. They should be able to pick this up. One player in position is Gizmo. And Cresty could play this smart. Nice play from Cresty. He knew there was two players. He heard the footsteps. He wasn't sure where Cresty had gone. Cresty just misses the flag on the respawn as well, I think. His teammates did spawn back. They did indeed. But they're almost there. They're almost in the halls. And I think that was the allies just sort of clearing it out. They weren't 100% sure where people were. Nick, top defense. It has to hold on strong. This is what I was talking about earlier, about like experience. This isn't normally how you play. When you saw the Ducks play, you saw Cresty and Stray doing exactly the same, but Fireball, he was downstairs. He was at that tree. He knew how to play. You defend at the tree, because you can use the tree for cover, easy revive cover. You can't get out. You can't get out towards any area without getting past the tree. And it leaves you time to respawn back in as well, and go aggressive in the North Halls. They are going to be able to pick up that objective. Cresty falls to his death, but he can quickly pass that off. No one's in position to grab that. But it doesn't seem like the allies are too aware that the objective is still there. Gizmo did actually return that. But that was like quite a well-known strategy. Swedish teams used to like to do that early on. It's just jump out of here with the objective, crush yourself on the floor, and then someone down here just picks it up. It's nice when it works. It's nice when it works, let's put it that way. As the up top defense is still holding on. I see some talk about times in chat. Do remember that times are percentage, not actual times. Just so you know. As the push comes across the top, airstrike is down. And there comes the kill. Stray taken down. It's going to be Fireball against Hybrid Tech. Last two players alive. Nice shooting from Fireball. And he sort of kept him stuck against the wall. He is going to go straight down. And Fireball, full of confidence with the new mouse and the old map. He knows this one inside out. He's going to just push straight through north, very speedy. And he shouldn't be run into too much resistance unless they're quick on south. Cresty's in position to try and slow them down. Stray's there as well. Nice shooting from Cresty. He did sort of mess up his aim a little bit there. But he managed to finish off that kill. And we are going to see Fireball just speed on home. They are going to close out that 4-0 victory. And objective captured. Well, Ice was a little bit disappointing, I think. But, I mean, delivery was as well. Cresty picking up 23 frags, 3.8k damage. Fireball 18, 3.5k. It's going to be a 4-0 victory for Ducks. And they're going to move on to the grand final. They're going to move on to that grand final where they'll face the winner of the lower bracket final, which will be played out later.